What's up, everyone? Welcome to the third part of the 25k review from the Scoop Final Table. Yes, I lost my hair. We were drunk and shaved it. Stupid story, but shit happens. let's get into the review. Last time we saw the sick bluff by Isildur that got hero called by King Jack, which was really intense. Also, we see some sick plays this time around as well. Yeah, just back to normal. Right now, Probius is all the fucking chips if you look around, man, with that hero call. It sits on 140 big blinds where everybody else is pretty short. 15, 15, 20, 30, 10 big blinds and 15. It's a great spot for him to apply pressure here. I mean, Huang theoretically should be flatting here, but obviously now with him being so short, there's just no value in it. We saw a bunch of ace 4 off folds in the big blind before in similar spots like this. So I wouldn't be surprised to see just a fold here, given other stack sizes, but I'm still not 100% sure how they play short stack, so we'll see. From where Pro makes the defend here. You see the finishing for 90,000 in caches in the end. It's a pretty ICM disaster there. We see the defend. I would assume if he had like... yeah, I don't know, to be honest. It's a close spot. Obviously, flop, he could see bad, just apply some pressure. But it's also a board that hits Romeo Pro very well. And he's going to get check jammed on a lot. So just check back give up seems also fine. This is a turn that Romeo Pro should definitely check. I mean, you don't have a clear value bet. When he checks back the flop, he says like ace check, ace 10, and all of that stuff. So you should just try to... look for showdown value. Now on the river, I mean, he mostly has the best hand, I would say, but there's still like some ace X that he's chopping with and like some 8-7, 8-6s, pocket 8s. I wouldn't even hate just a check back here, a check from Romeo, just because it's tough to get value here. And with your hand, you just wanted to get to showdown, kind of. Especially with ICM, you know, there's just not that much value to squeeze in a little bit of value. Maybe he goes for a block bet. Yeah, okay, so he goes for the block bet. And I expect to just see a fold here, yeah. Which makes sense as well, you know, block bet seems fine. You don't want to go, like, aggressive for value there, even though you mostly have the best hand, but just in this situation, it's kind of fucked. Seems like Rothschaff is going to flip it here. Seems like an easy rejam. He's the shortest deck. Got to look for his spots. He has fold equity with 10 big blinds here, just given how wide Probius is going to open. Like, he's going to have King 3 offsuit here that folds to jam. And maybe hand like 7-5 offsuit, 7-4 offsuit, you know, so definitely goes for it. Obviously, with the pocket pair, he's never folding, and he never should here. And the run keeps on going. I mean, that King Jack call in the last episode was obviously pretty sick. But you know, you also need to run well to win tournaments. We see a nice combination of the two things from him. Sure, gonna skip that. This is going to be interesting for Romeo Pro if he wants to open here. He can definitely apply a lot of pressure to the stack sizes because he covers them. King Samov seems like a decent hand to open here, but we'll see if he actually goes for it. It's kind of weird. They don't want to play back that much, yeah. I would go for it here, but always excited to see what actually happens. Now RuneF probably regens a bunch of his ASX preflop, so I expect Romeo to just c-bet here, since he mostly has the best hand. And just performs better on this board, and we just see the fold from King High. Alright, so back. Now, I kind of forgot that we used a different program to review it last time. I think one shouldn't be opening here with Probius in the big blind, who's going to play back a bit, and these other shots, like, it's just not a spot with... being second in chips, you just want to relax. You have 30 big blinds, the other guy 13 and 12. You just fold, and wait for your spots. They did ace it offsuit, it's even a marginal open to begin with, like chippy device, probably even losing with those decks behind. So I think in this spot, it's like clearly a fold. Yeah, on the flop, I wouldn't hate a c-bet just because his range should be quite tight, and therefore he should have an advantage over Probius' range. And a c-bet. Could just take the pot down. Yeah, it's probably here, but definitely pressure. You know, your chip stack, he's the guy that doesn't want to lose chips. I would just fire out a 70% bet. You have plenty of good hands here. Two pairs, straights. Nguyen has obviously, like, my perceived range is going to have a bunch of checks, tens, ace king, ace check, you know, hands like that. Ace five suited, maybe. So this is also a lovely river to pull through on. I mean, the one downside is that we don't block any hearts that one calls us with on the flop turn. You know, hand like king eight would be a better bluff with the king of hearts, for example, because we block ace king of hearts. But I would just go for like a cheap bluff here, probably. Okay, it goes quite big. I'll probably go a bit smaller to represent more like straights and stuff, but that seems fine as well. Alright, we're just gonna see an open jam here from Vizo and then a fold. That's pretty unsurprising. Clear fold, probably just puts in the pressure and one should just fold. Yeah, I think this is just like, obviously this is a fine defend versus a button open chip device, but once again with the entire situation, these are short stacks. It's just not really your spot to be opening. Or to be defending and going for these marginal profitable spots. Like, now you already find yourself in this tough spot. Obviously, it's an easy call versus a wide range. But on the turn, you're going to be facing lots of pressures again. And then it's just tough to continue. You know, like, even here on the turn, probably it's just double barrels. The wrong hands to fold here. So, it's a problem with the marginal preflop defend, in my opinion. I would just let it go there. Bruce checks it back on the turn. So, it's not the best hand to double barrel. And I'm not sure how much they've seen from Ron, so don't know how. I mean, I think they know him very well. They play often in these high roll events. So he just goes up after flop call, which is pretty reasonable. Obviously, you see a king 3, and then we're like, okay. Seems like a decent spot to double barrel. Also, looks like they are going on break here. So we're quickly going to skip through that. Right, kings with the open, 92 with the flat. Once again, like, same story. One just fold, let it go. Big blind comes along as well. Now we have a very interesting spot. Vizo's range here should be, like, incredibly tight when he opens up 14 bigs. Obviously, I expect to see that occasional king queen or something like that, but not too much. One goes for the lead. Obviously, there's nothing to say about that. It's just not good. But now Romeo, yeah, he has to muck it here. I mean, you have a player behind. Vizo's range is incredibly tight here, as I said. Not incredibly tight, but pretty damn tight. So you don't really want to float there that short. Especially not on the final table. Just to see if you see flat here or raise. I mean, with kings and a spade, it seems like you mostly want to call. But he just goes for the pile. Let's see if one finds the fold here. I mean, he gets pretty great odds at this point, right? 1 million to win 2 million. So it's tough to call, tough to fold. Obviously, against kings, he only has 20%, but against most other hands, like, let's say, if he thinks he has an ace 4, ace 5, there's some space, he's doing pretty good. But yeah. Probably is clearly opening here. Romeo Pro, closest spot, I would say, with ace 7 against the, like, 100% opening range. Not quite 100, but 70, 80%. Maybe like 70%, so. It's close, not quite sure. That one comes down to ICM, I would say. Clear defend from Ole. It's kind of funny, it probably is actually. This is like opposite spot, you know. You expect that, oh, he opens 70%, he never has a hand here, but sometimes he has. Seabird is pretty standard in the spot, I think. And it's kind of dirty. just lets it go. Yeah, it's weird, man. Like, obviously, usually it's like a clear raise or call with ace-9 there, but you're never folding once again. Now he has 3 million, so it's in a great spot covering everybody and just doesn't want to get any spots. So it does make sense to be really tight. See, that one just goes through. We just see some folds here. Ace-3, also no surprise, not with a million stack. And it's just a cutoff, you know, you don't want to open these hands. Clear open champ for king-check, and then check for suited just folds. Pretty standard spots. These spots are so incredibly complicated, man. Like, you don't usually end up on a fine table with four people with, like, similar stacks like that. That's just absurd. But goes for the open and gets it through. But it also, as I said, makes it tough to play back. Whereas it's the 17, 18 big man stacks. You can't read three but fold. So you are always committing yourself by jamming. I think probably should definitely induce here with ace jack. He's going to be opening so many hands in the button. Yeah, I don't really like this. Just for the reason, he's going to be opening so many hands in the button. Yes, those guys don't have much incentive to rejam over your open. But it's still like much more likely they're going to rejam ace-8. I mean, the downside of opening is obviously that one likes to defend his big blinds, the wider. We saw the king-3, so you give a bit of, like, you give them a chance to see a good flop. But it's still would like an induce here over the jam. Obviously, it's profitable, but I think it's not going to be as profitable as raise calling and then giving them the opportunity to rejam hand like a7. King jack, you know. And that should just be an open. Let's see, for me a pro defense. Nope. Open jam. Pretty standard all around here. Oh, goes into the tank with the sixes. It's a dirty spot, man. He covers the three other guys now that sit on 14 big blinds each. He commits himself here with the sixes. This is kind of interesting, man. With king queen, you can almost call now. But yeah, he gets in pretty tight, so it makes sense to just fold. The reason he does that once again is if we see two other regems in the call, then he can fold, I think. But yeah. It's a bit crazy. I think it's a profitable spot against the wide opening range, obviously, but you gotta be careful. Oof. I mean, I guess it makes some sense again. That's pretty crazy. Just if Probius wakes up with a hand, you're just so fucked. Shorts the guy's in spot, man. I think it's a profitable jam, though. Just runs into ace queen. Bink. Ooh, double bink. Goodbye, sir. I wouldn't. Like, 23 big blinds here. You have an profitable open jam for sure with the king six suited. One. Yeah, his nine call seems reasonable. Want to put some distance between you and the other guys. Oh, that's a sick run out. Chop it up. Weird spot for Romeo. Like, this just depends how much older plays back, right? We have a 12 big blind and a 14 big blind stack, so you obviously want to limp this hand here, but if Ole plays back a lot or jams back a lot, then you're just in an awful, awful spot, so it seems too tight to just open fold, but maybe that's the right play. Like, I think this is pretty close. With 8-5 suited, I think he would just open folded. We'll see what he ends up doing. It ends up open folding, right? Yeah. And I didn't hate it. Said the spot is quite unique, so you gotta be careful. Deuce is clear, leave folding here. I mean, probably it's 2-6 suited now, like, he is very right. Anything that's suited is an open in his shoes, but it just works with these exercises, so yeah. Living the dream. I mean, Ole has a great stack now, 40 big blinds, clearly the second in chips, you know, so just gotta be cautious as well. Probably thinks if he even wants to, like, just open back the a7, I might assume. Yeah, he just goes for it. That's so crazy. That is so crazy. But with the stack, it makes sense. Oh, it's a cool ace queen versus king's blind versus blind. That's ridiculous. And one with the double. That's absurd. Decent hand for Probus to flat or 3-bet. Probably flatting is not that idea, because usually it's just a nice hand to flat here against the hijack open. But given that Visa's opening range is not that wide in this spot, probably better as a 3-bet. And king-queen off here, man, I think this is just a fold. We saw him open fold a7 off before, and it's just really not a great spot for you with these other short stacks to be defending. It flops really well, right? But even if you have a king-high flop and you face 3-bets, man, it's going to be incredibly tough. And then you gotta hope for that flop, and then you gotta hope that your opponent doesn't have it this time. So, yeah. Not surprised to see that fold. I see aces. Goes for his 4.5x open. Once again, it makes sense. You wanna have some hands here that you 4.5x like fold if all of the four other guys go all in. I think I mentioned this often enough, so you guys know what's happening there now. Ole with the ace check now. I think he should be flighting here. I mean, you don't want to 3-bet. I mean, you could 3-bet fold it, I guess. But seems quite nice as a flat as well. And this is probably just probably c-betting and taking it down. It's my prediction here. This is once again the issue with ace-jack offsuit. Probably has such a wide range that he still has all the 2x and a 10x. And if you call here and rune f-jams, you're just in a world of pain. So, dream spot for Probus. But actually has the best hand this time. On that flop. 8 and off should be pretty close. In the spot versus the jam. I mean, I expect to see a fold, but it's getting close to like a chippy V call. See here with ICM, I don't think you want to be doing too much. Let's see what sizing he picks here, blind versus blind. I mean, I definitely expect him to raise maybe like a 4x, 3.5x. So he comes in with the 3 point something x, 3.1, 3.2. And now we'll just expect a rejam from sevens. Probably is just going to fold heaps here. But okay, he goes for the passive route. Queen 5 deuce. So now, if he's, I mean, one always likes flatting a bit wide than other people, so he might break the board still like a decent amount of the time. So I like to see, but against other people, maybe it's just a check fold, but this position obviously makes sense to apply some pressure. Might see a double barrel here with the 9 of clubs, you know, blocking some hands that would call the turn, float flop. Yeah, not sure. Yeah, just an out-of-line bluff, but why not, you know? Moron would still have, like, a decently wide flop range. Just falls on the turn, yeah. I think that's just a clear regen pre-flop. You just put yourself in an awkward spot that you shouldn't be in. Pocket 8 just takes it down pre. King 5 off, just taking it down pre. Falls the queen 5 off, you know. Not quite sure why. No, no, it's like 6 to suited. I guess maybe because rune f is that short now. Yeah. I think he gets a walk if 10-5 off suit, yeah. Surprised. Aces. It's kind of a weird spot because you don't really have a limping range in this position. We've seen like him playing incredibly tight, so. Would be kind of a weird spot to limp, so he might just see a jam here because he only jams hands. He goes for this 2.5x. I mean, very, very odd in my opinion. But yeah. I think I probably just jam aces there. Clear open jam with ace king. I mean, there's nothing else you want to be doing. Yeah. Effective open jam. And Pikmin should just fold. And 3 takes it down. 10-4. Finds a rejam. Could be profitable, obviously, with this deck, but he's quite even with the other guys. This is probably his wide, wide opening range. I obviously like it, but it's always tough to nail point it down. If it would be correct with ICM or not. Romeo Pro basically goes all in here. And was he like a 5x fold here? No, okay. Oh, the spike. Good time to hit 3 outers. Damn, that's brutal. Now he has a decent stack. Me so crippled. Yeah, 10-9 should be a jam. That's why you went tournament, boys. Wow, the needle. I think it's fine between the guys, obviously. It's funny. It's not really a needle either. It's just funny to win such a big sword to just type it out in the chat. See if Probus open jams this one and goes for like a 3x call. Yeah, I personally like a raise in the spot. You dominate a lot of the hands that he's calling you with, and if he rejams, you're usually just doing fine enough with King Queen 2 to call off. Obviously, one gonna be. I mean, he's gonna be insanely tight if you flat 7s here. He was a bit deeper earlier, but still. That's a 10-9. Checks the flop now. This puts always interesting, just because with ICM pressure, you can just c-bet so much wider than usual. Which just makes it a bit more complicated. Just tries to go to showdown with the king queen. Well, I should be tempted to bet the turn here, I think. But just checks it again. Does he find a small bet now? Nope, just gives up a 10 high. King high wins. And would be very tempted to stab the turn there. I just want to see if he piles it here or raises. Just goes for a jam. Yeah, I think raising would be better on that spot. Now, interesting spot because Romeo Bro has so many profitable jams here. The limp is pretty suspicious. Maybe he goes for like a 2.5x. No, he does limp. Don't expect the Ole to play back much here. Just because it doesn't make sense that Romeo Pro has a wide limping range in this situation. Right, it's just. You have so many profitable jams. Oh, this could be trouble. That could be trouble. Because I don't expect Romeo Pro to limp any Queen X. Ace Queen, King Queen, Queen Deuce offsuit, all of those are profitable jams in this situation with these other short stacks where Ole has to fold a lot of hands. So I do believe that generally with a 9 here, you feel like you have the best hand most of the time. Besides, there are obvious traps that I feel are there very often. What up, boy? Tifumo comes in with a late bet. Seems like a turn you've only been betting. I feel like this is often a turn by the time spot. By the time you arrive on the turn, you kind of sometimes forget slightly about the preflop ranges and that you were a bit suspicious that you limped off 11, 12 big blinds when you were like with this ICM. So yeah, he finds the fold. That's obviously like a ridiculous fold in a normal scenario, but here I like it very much. That's pretty clean. That's a sexy fold there. 3-9 off, ain't no thing. Easy open. He limps the ace and suited now. That's just to keep the pot a bit smaller. You see the button and the small blind being very short. He doesn't want to make raise and face a lot of field spots against the big blind or bigger pots. So now Probius obviously has like a very wide range. There's many, many hands that will just completely break this. I'm not quite sure how the ranges interact here because Romeo Pro doesn't have a wide limping range, right? Usually when we play against our day-to-day opponents, when people limp, they have usually like 50%, 40% of hands. Romeo Pro is not gonna have anything near that. So yeah, I'm not quite sure how the ranges interact in the spot textures. I expect Romeo Pro to have a decent advantage though given his tight limping range. And I think here on the 10 turn he should have the best hand most of the time, so I expect like a I would bet here on the bigger side, like something like 250k. Build a pot. Yeah, that's pretty accurate. Get ready from quite a few hands. We see a snap throw from check 7 there. Open ender and a pair. Yeah, I guess it's fine just because Romeo doesn't have a wide limping range probably. And but I would lean towards a call there with the check 7. Open enders are pretty good. But obviously, they have the flush draws out there as well, so yeah. Don't hate it. Ooh, close spot with A7 suited. Obviously, usually just an easy call. I feel like really close there. Really close. Could be a call, could not be a call. It's really weird because Ruin F has 900k chips right now, right? So. Maybe his name is Ruin NF, by the way. Ace4 should probably just defend here. But the other stacks are so short now, it's crazy. Expect to see a third pot bet and maybe just a fold on the flop. Okay, he checks it back now. I mean, very reasonable with Queen 5. It's obviously not a hand that plays particularly great with a flop bet. and you both have wide ranges. It's not that you have an insane like range advantage here, given that he just opens pretty much any two on the button, and he also open jams king queen and stuff like that. So there's a lot of weak hands here. But the ace4, you just try to get to showdown. Maybe the 4-5 suited. Goes for a check down. Story behind the shaved heads. We were just drunk and went for it. Not too much besides that. No third pot value bet on the river. Very reasonable. I think as Romeo probably just fold here. Expect a lot of hands to just bet the flop already. And yeah, that's the main reason I would just fold here. And he makes it. Nice fold. Queen 6 open, takes it down. King check, just an open jam. And that's going to be a cross spot for Ole. Very cross spot. Oh, Rui is so short here, man. No, Romeo should be jamming very right as well here. Very interesting spot. I kind of like the fold, to be honest. I kind of like the fold. Damn, it's a dirty spot. You see another limp, same reasons. A6 off doesn't go for the rejam. Yeah, I don't expect to see a super wide open limping range there either, so yeah, not surprised. Probably puts on the pressure with a huge raise. throws out the 5.5x. And ace pursuit, you just got a market here. I mean, what are you going to do with the other stack sizes? There's literally nothing. Believe in hell, don't you? I mean, looking at the sizing, yes. Easy open jam with the 7-5, keep the pressure up. Older with the open jam with ace-queen, seems pretty reasonable. And I think this is the not of defend this time. Rui down to 5 big blinds, I think ace is off, you just gotta mark it here. Also Wang is like short now, you cover him. Yeah, that's a good fold. Ace-9, easy jam. And we'll live with the open jam, yeah, and then Rui has an easy call, and we're gonna run it. No help, and now Ole is short stack. Yeah, it's like three guys with under 10 BB now. Easy open jam for Probius from with the snap call, snap fold, obviously. Ooh, no. That check it must be like, this is like a clear fold. Like 100% is this a fold. 100%. Gets it through though, good timing, but nope. That is absolutely disgusting with pocket eights here. In Romeo Pro shoes. I think this is a fold, if it's folded to you. I'm not sure if one was gonna like, I would say punt call fives. But I think pocket eights in this spot, yeah, like that fives is a fold. I mean, pocket eights snap fold at that point, but even versus if you folded, I think you're folding pocket eights there. The ACM is cray cray. That's absolutely insane. I think eights are marked there with pocket tens. We get into the area where we want to call. But there's Romeo Pro with those letters. There's just no business for you calling. One gets rewarded for the call, but I do not like it. What do you call here? In Romeo's shoes, I'm calling. Yeah, 10s plus, I think. But I'm not even sure about 10s, man. It's pretty fucked. You see the rejam and the fold. One comes in with the open now after double. Yeah, I think 10s plus, maybe checks plus. The thing is, like, Probius hasn't been that off. I mean, we've seen his cards, right? It's always tough to think about what our opponents have seen and what we have seen. But we've seen Probius open jam hands like king, queen suited for 25 big blinds, king jack suited now for 20-something bigs. So it's not that he's going to open jam. Like, he hasn't been open jamming hands like 9-5 suited or something like that. He only has been open jamming hands that are doing pretty good against hands like 10s, you know? So I feel like his open jamming range is not even that absurdly wide. meaning that you wouldn't perform particularly great against it with 10s, nor even checks. And this is just a tough spot to analyze, because we cannot really nail down his open jamming range, because he clearly has a jamming range, but also a raising range. Of these guys, as it goes, obviously it's a 25k online event. I mean, one played this one pretty conservatively, but makes sense with the stack sizes. 3s is an easy fold. Check 9 tries him with the, himself with the limp. Expect to just see a check here. I mean, I don't know what reads they have in Wang, so tough to say. Checks is still a horrible spot. Yeah, true, it's absurd. Might just be something like queens, kings, aces that you call there. Very tough spot. Just ridiculous stupid, because the other guys are so short, like, so stupid. Let's see if Romeo comes in with the stab. Alright, interesting turn. Ace King suited plus 10s plus. I think you never call Ace King there. I could be wrong. It's just, we cannot analyze the spot because we don't know what the jamming range looks like. Seems like a very reasonable turn, but now you have to have best hand almost always. You want to get value. And now I expect to just see a check on the river, and Romeo might value bet this. It's just kind of unlikely that Wang steps the turn too often with an ace that doesn't make two pair on the river and wants to value bet himself. So I would feel pretty confident about having the best hand here with ace 5 of clubs. I'm probably throwing like a smallish value bet against Wang and try to trigger it called. I mean, I guess he could have had like ace 8, but even that he would probably like try to value bet in the river. So expect to see a value bet now. Ooh, and he goes for the very big bet, which I like. You want to polarize yourself as well. I would probably just go for a small bet, just to be exploitive, and try to get like the crying call from a 9 or 7. But obviously this makes more sense, because 6-5 bricks and stuff like that, so you might incline him more to hero call. That's very sexy. That's a very, very sexy sizing on the river. Oh, he's in the tank, man. This is a very tough spot with a 9. But he finds the fold. Oh, I love that value bet with ace 5, man. So like what I mean, what I like to see in like good players, they do certain things with such confidence, you know. A lot of us, like when we go in a world for value there, we choose a small sizing something bigger, but he just knows he has the best hand there and just goes for it. Sorry. Oh, wrong button. There's the open. Weird spot with ace 6 suited. Given a shot, the big blind is, you might just fold here, but he goes for the rejam. I mean, Wang should clearly be open jamming here, not raising. I think this is also like a crazy rejam. Like, he does this because he knows Wang. Against most people, I would just expect to fold there. Just in a situation where the big blind is so short and you really don't expect people to open wide on the button there. Queen check now with the snap call. I mean, he's very short here, clearly short, so gotta go for it. Oh, sorry. Let's see the run out. Rip. All out in fifth place. Getting a bit unlucky there, and cash is 200k. Not that bad. I mean, it's only an 8x. But yeah. Probably gonna 3x this again. Yep, that's 3.5x. And I mean, if one doesn't jam this one, then I'm gonna lose it. Alright, there we go. These spots with ace off close, but he just snap marks it. I mean, it makes sense as well, but I feel it would be much closer than that. Bit of banter going on, another limp. I like these limbs. Goes for the small stab and probably with the raise. I mean, he can just put on the pressure here, so why not do it for value as well? Romeo comes in with the call. I mean, with that sizing, you obviously gotta continue. I love the stupid random trash talking of 25k FT. Always fun. Yo, cheers for the host, Saros. Fire's turn. I mean, you expect to have the best hand here most of the time, right? So, just makes sense to go for that value. An easy fold in turn with ace 5. Pretty standard. Ace 9 should re-jam for sure against Probus here. And he does that and takes it down. Okay. It's a dirty spot with ace 3. I mean, you have fold equity when you jam here. And Probus opens very wide. This could be a profitable re-jam. It's really tough to play this as a defend, I think, against that sizing. Just because you're going to have a flop like this so often and you don't do anything. So maybe re-jamming is better pre-flop. I kind of like it over calling. It's just a replay from the last scoop series. Let's see. I mean, definitely want to go for value now, and I expect to just see a fold from ace to three. Even if you had on a turn here, like you're gonna face that barrel so often. And, it's also a board, but you expect to see a high c-bet frequency. King queen now with the raise. So it makes the queen check hand even clearer as a raise, right? Because we saw him raise king queen offsuit. So with queen check, you are mostly ahead there. Kind of an interesting flop because in Romeo's shoes, if you see like a check jam here, you're in a world of motherfucking pain with rune F being so short. So this might be a spot where he decides to check back. And we see exactly that. I kind of like that. That's what I think I would be doing since I think a little bit more about it. Just giving a short raise once again. And if you check jam, you're just in the worst spot ever. Obviously a great turn. This should just go like check bet call. He eventually goes for a small block bet. Yeah, I don't like it, but yeah. I just think you should be polarized in your leading range on the turn here. Romeo makes the call and improves to a flush. No, Wang is in this weird spot. It's tough to analyze it just because the turn sizing doesn't make too much sense. I mean, obviously with this hand it makes sense. So like it's not awful or anything, but just not what I would do. Quickly gonna skip to the time bank. Let's see how big the sizing is going to be. I don't expect one to call here ever. He goes for the overbet. I think all he's doing here is pretty much exploitatively against his opponent there. Just takes it down again. Open jam and folds. Does he open jam this? Yep, he does. Makes sense. Ooh, I mean, I expect to see an open jam here, but we might see a call as well with King Deuce. Yep. Run it. Oh, shit. Oh, that was close. Easy game for Probus. And right here, we're gonna take a quick break and then come back with the last part of this video with the three-handed game, probably with a big, big chip lead. Let's see if you can take it down. If you enjoyed this video, guys, don't forget to subscribe button. I'll see you in the next episode. Take care.